Hello, and welcome to another edition of Federal Flash, the Alliance for Excellent Education's weekly video series on important developments in education policy in Washington, D.C. I'm Bob Wise, President of the Alliance for Excellent Education. I'm joined by Phillip Lovell, the Alliance's Vice President for Policy and Advocacy. In the next 5 minutes, that's all, 5 minutes, we will highlight what's happened in federal education policy this week and give you a preview of what we can expect next week. So, Phillip, the Senate Education Committee keeps working on ESEA. Another hearing this week. What happened?
So this week's hearing, Bob, was focusing on teachers and leaders. And basically, we saw the divisions between the Republicans and the Democrats, I think, more firmly crystallized. Essentially, from the Republican point of view, the answer to everything is flexibility. And from the Democratic point of view, they want to see a lot more federal direction with the resources. Although the topic of the hearing was teachers and leaders, certainly the issue of assessments definitely came up, and that'll, I think, continue to be a theme.
The Republican Senate leadership was predicting a mid-February markup. That's just a couple of weeks away. Is that likely? And if so, are there negotiations between the two parties taking place?
So it's an excellent question. They're definitely still working towards a February markup. It may not be early, mid-February. It might slip towards the end of the month, but they're definitely still working towards that February markup. Now, what that means is that there really isn't time for actual thorough bipartisan negotiations. So if they're going to move that fast, it's going to be a partisan bill.
So that's the Senate. Last week, nothing much happening in the House. What about this week as far as ESEA?
So with the House, Chairman John Klein gave his opening speech around the ESEA reauthorization and other education priorities last week. Next week, we hear that they'll be introducing their bill. They could be marking that bill up the following week.
So if they're marking a bill up in a two-week period in the House, that tells me no discussions are taking place of significance in the House between Republican leadership and Democratic leadership, right?
I think we will see a very similar markup happening this year as we saw last year, which basically means a partisan markup.
And so what about the administration? What's up with it this week?
So the big news for the administration really is that on Monday, they're going to be releasing their annual budget request. Remember, this is where the administration outlines what it wants for each federal program for the coming year. So we'll get some additional details on some of what the president requested or mentioned in the State of the Union, for example.
Predictions for the education budget?
So we'll probably see an increase. We'll see language around early childhood. We'll see definitely the language around community college. And we'll see some language around ESEA, definitely.
And is there another hearing next week in the Senate?
Next Tuesday. They're calling this one a roundtable. There may be some more back and forth between the senators and the witnesses. This one's going to be focused on innovation.
Okay. So, Phillip, anything else we ought to be looking for next week?
So next week we have this hearing. We've got the president's budget. Anyone who wants to weigh in formally with the Senate on the Alexander draft, comments are due on Monday. You can send an email to fixingnclb@help.senate.gov. One other thing to note of what happened this week, the Senate Committee on Health, Education, Labor, and Pensions, they reported out, they passed the reauthorization of the Education Sciences Reform Act. I think we mentioned that last week. So they're moving on that, going to try to get that passed. But ESEA is definitely the big enchilada.
Still moving. So that's it. We've done it again. All the federal news and education in 5 minutes in the 5-minute Federal Flash. For an email alert when the next episode of Federal Flash is available, email us at alliance@allfored.org. Get your own personal notification. Thank you for watching.